You have until July 1st to migrate your Universal Analytics to GA4. So here's how to migrate Universal Analytics to Google Analytics 4, including how to add GA4 to your website. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and I make a ton of content like this, but today is all about Google Analytics 4 migration. So let's jump into my Google Analytics to learn how to migrate to Google Analytics 4 using the GA4 Migration Assistant. So I'm signed into my Google account and I just went to analytics.google.com to access Google Analytics. And if you haven't migrated to GA4 yet, your analytics may look similar to mine. I've got a big pop-up with a countdown telling me that this property will stop processing data starting July 1st, 2023. And in this pop-up, I can click on the Go to Setup Assistant button to begin the migration process. But you should also have a red bar along the top of your homepage showing you a similar message with a big red Begin Migration button in the top right corner, which I will talk more about in just a sec. By the way, before we start this migration process, if you have no idea what I'm talking about, I recommend watching this video here to learn what Google Analytics is and how to add Google Analytics to your website. Then come back and watch this video. So you might notice in that warning bar at the top that if you do nothing, a GA4 property may be created for you unless you opt out. So this is like the lazy person's way of migrating, but I really wouldn't rely on that because there could be a glitch and sometimes data might not transfer properly between the old GA3 and this new GA4 because they're essentially like different platforms. So with that said, we're gonna go ahead and click on the Go to Setup Assistant button to get started setting up GA4. So here we are in the admin section of our GA4 Setup Assistant. And you're gonna know that you're working with the old Universal Analytics property if your tracking ID starts with UA-. So here we can either create a new Google Analytics 4 property or we can connect an existing GA4 property. Since I haven't created a GA4 property yet, I'm gonna select the first option by clicking Get Started. In this pop-up, we're told what this setup assistant will do, and also this enables data collection using existing analytics is toggled off, and I wanna leave it toggled off. Sometimes there are issues with tag customizations and data being reported, so I do not wanna click that. Even here underneath, there's a warning that existing tag customizations can't be migrated. So all I'm gonna do here is click on Create and Continue. So here we are in the Setup a Google Tag option. For me, since I already have a Google tag installed on my site, that is selected at the top and showing here. But it tells me that my tag has settings that will be lost if I just use this tag. If I continue, that will overwrite existing settings. So your tag setup page may look a little bit different depending on whether or not you already have a tag set up or what website you have connected. So you might have a little install with Squarespace or install with Wix option at the top. The absolute easiest way is for you to install using that first choice to say install with Squarespace if that's your option. So though this would be easiest for me, I wanna walk you through the install manually option so that you could see how to manually do this. When you select the manual option, you can copy and paste this code to every page of your website as per the instructions. But it's okay if you miss this step right now. You may have a confirm button in the top right or a test installation option. So here's what's gonna happen. If you click on test installation option, you're gonna get an error because obviously you haven't added that code to your website yet. But that's fine because we can get to it from another spot, which I want you to know about because this is really good if you start this process and then you get distracted and life happens. No worries, you can get to this again later. So I'm gonna skip this for now. And here we go, the new GA4 property has been created, though not properly connected. So now let's click on Go to your GA4 property. Here, a new tab is opened and you can see I'm 0 of 7 steps completed. So let's fix this. Click on Data Streams And here I have my website, which, by the way, if you have apps or multiple data streams you want to collect data from, then you could add that here. But I'm going to click on my website data stream. From here, I'll click on the view tag instructions. And here is our code again that we saw previously. So this is where you would find that again. So we have to copy and paste this over to our website. Or easier yet, and why I do this from this section, is because if you click on the option to install with website builder or CMS, you can pick your supported platform. So I'll pick Wix for me because that's my website builder. And this is way easier than copying and pasting that code to each page of my site. Goodness gracious. So now all you're gonna have to do is follow the instructions for how to add a Google tag to your site. It's typically in like a marketing integration section, or you might have a third-party app that might help you. So for my Wix site, I'm gonna copy my tag, and then I'm gonna head to my Wix account. And on the site dashboard, I'll go to the marketing and SEO section and select marketing integrations. Here, what you would do is hit connect if you've never connected before. But assuming that you're migrating from Universal Analytics, you're gonna already have that connected. So click on view. And then from here, we're gonna click on the three-dot menu icon in the top right and select edit. Here, I'm gonna paste in my new GA4 code. And then I'm gonna click on save. Boom. We've now edited the Google integration just like that. So let's head back to our analytics and go back to our setup assistant. It's still going to show that we are 0 of 7 complete, but if you followed those steps and you've added your Google tag to your website, then you can mark this step complete. So once you have gone through all of these settings and figured out what works for you and marked them as complete, that red bar at the top will go away. By the way, let's switch back over to our other analytics tab under that UA property we have. You can toggle off the option to automatically set up a basic GA4 property, or you can leave it toggled on if you're creating a GA4 property before July 1st, or if you just simply want to roll the dice and have Google automatically migrate all of this for you. Okay, I think that covers the Google Analytics 4 setup, so hopefully you've learned how to easily migrate your Universal Analytics to GA4. Phew! So now I want to hear from you. Did you migrate in a different way, or did you run into any problems? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and look at that! Here and here for even more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.